In this video, I will present some Python packages that can be used together to build a web interface which displays data loaded into the SAS Cloud Analytic Services and with models deployed into SAS Micro Analytics Services. Let's start with Dash. Dash is a Python framework developed by Plotly. Its main purpose is to easily build web interfaces to visualize results from machine learning and data science-related tasks using the Python language. Using Dash, you can quickly build a web application which includes interactions between different objects based on pandas data frames and with little to no knowledge about web development. Using the callback function in Dash makes it easy to build links between components of the web application in a Pythonic way. We'll now move to the first SAS provided package. The scripting wrapper for analytics transfer, also named SWAT for intimate, is a Python package developed and provided by SAS to interact with the gas server from Python and other languages like R and Lua. You can easily develop your code using Jupyter notebooks or any other IDE supporting Python execution. The SWAT package provides functionalities that are similar to the pandas data frames to access and manipulate gas tables. It can be used to access the gas servers through binary or HTTP protocol. The SWAT package handles the connection to the gas server and lets the data scientist analyze and model data using their preferred language, Python. The SASCTL package is another Python package provided by SAS. It is designed to load open source models into SAS VIA and interact with them. Like the SWAT package for the interactions with the gas server, SASCTL is developed by SAS to ease interaction with SAS REST APIs. While the initial purpose was to control the model lifecycle for tasks like development, registration, publishing, testing, or comparison, SASCTL provides also more functionalities which were needed to serve the original purpose, like SAS logo, files, and folders. It provides create, read, update, and delete methods for many SAS REST API endpoints, and also provides a standard version in case you want to access an endpoint that is not covered. Let's go for a little demo. I will open up Visual Studio Code, which is my preferred IDE. You can also use Jupyter Notebook if you want. Let's start with a simple Dash application. You see here we will just create a Hello World application. Previously, I've installed Dash on my Python environment, as well as the SWAT package and the SASCTL package. Let's just run the application. My application is starting and we will see the result directly. Let me move to the browser. Right. You see, here I've only displayed Hello World. What is the code? The code is creating a Dash application and defining the layout of our application. We are just adding an HTML div, and in that HTML div, we have a child, which is Hello World, the text that we have seen. After that, we run the application. Let's close that application and move to the next one. In the Hello World, we want to make it a bit more interactive. So in this case, I will import some specific functions from Dash, like the Dash input, output state, and callback, DCC, and HTML. We are again building a Dash application, and in that Dash application, defining a layout. In the layout, we have an HTML div with different children now. The first one is just a text, which is say NO2. Then we have an input box, an input field. It's a with an ID name, it's a text, and there is a placeholder. And finally, we have an HTML button, which displays the update text and the ID of this button. We finally display the message as a H1 header. The magic of Dash is that we can use callback functions, and the callback functions are using output, input, and state. So for example, the input is the button, we click on the button, and as soon as we click on the button, we are outputting something to the message children. In this case, the message is here, the ID of our H1 tag, and then we are populating the children. How do we do that? We use a state to store the name, and the name is the placeholder for the input field. We retrieve the value for that. We define a function that is used for the callback, and as soon as we click, we display a message based on the hello and then the name, the value of the field that we entered. If there is nothing, we just display hello world. Let's start the application. Know that the application started. We can go up here and you see that we have hello world displayed by default. We have the text field that we get enter, and let's enter my name and then update. As soon as I click update, it is refreshing. So you see with a really little code, you can create a layout and in that layout add functionalities through callback functions. Let's close the application and move to the first one that is integrating with SAS. So in this case, I've imported other Python packages, the pandas data frame, Blockly Express to display some graphs, the sweat package, and finally the dash input and output callback and DCC function from dash. I've defined a URL, which is my CAS server, and find a data source which stores data in a CSV format. I will give a name to a table, and the table will be stored into the CAS server and hold the data from this CSV file. So the first thing I will do is create a SWAT connection using the URL and the certificate. Then I will read the CSV file and load it into a table into CAS. As soon as that is done, I will create a dash application. And in that dash application, I will use the timesheet, the style sheet from Bootstrap, which is a nice component to improve the layout of your application. Then I define a component, the header bar, and this is coming with Bootstrap components. It's a navbar simple. I give an ID, I give a brand, the color, and I allow the dark theme. Then I build a container which will hold the application itself. The application will display the header bar. It will also display a select box, a graph, and finally a table with some rows. I've created a few callback functions to make the links between the different components. This one will update the graph as soon as we enter a selection in the filter and use the information from the filter to select which data will be part of the frame, of the data frame that should be displayed into a bar chart. I have another function, and the other function will display some detailed data as soon as I will click on the bar chart, selecting one specific car model. The data will be filtered and we will see the specific information about the car. We are using, again, data frame, so we are connecting to the table from the SWAT table and store the information into a data frame and display that as a list, and we are building the list in a card. We finally run the application. So let's start the application now. So what is happening behind the scene? We are connecting to this location to retrieve data and loading the data into the server. What we do here, and what we can see after refreshing, is that we have the bar at the top and the data coming from the CAS server. If I select here Asia instead of Europe, I can filter the result. I can do the same for USA, and After that, if I click on one of the bricks over here, I display the information about the car. So you see here that I have an invoice, and we will use the same information to score a model to predict the invoice or advise the better retail price, and we will do that using SASCTL. So with the SASCTL, I have here imported the SASCTL package. The SASCTL package will provide me access to the model that was deployed previously into the macro analytics services. You see here that I've hard-coded the username and the password. There is basically no need to hard-code it. You can build a prompt for that into Dash, but I was not willing to go to this level of details for this demo and just use hard-coded values. Again, we are loading the data from the cast into the cast table. So the data will be loaded into cast using the same code as in the previous example. Then we have a navbar where I have updated the title. And finally, we have the container, and the container contains the header bar, the selection for the region, the graph, and at the bottom to a row, and in the first row we have a column which displays the details, and another one which will display the scoring result. Again, we are using callback functions to update the graph as soon as we make a selection into the origin box. We do the same for the click on the graph to filter the data. And finally, we execute a call to the scoring model. And that scoring model is defined over here. It's defined over there. MSRP prediction is the name of my model, which is deployed. And this is using the mass execute. And in this case, we are connecting to the SASCTL. We are populating the result, and the result will be the predicted retail price. And we will display that in the card. Let's start the application. So during the startup, the application will load data into CAS. As soon as the data is available into CAS, we can then display the information. I will refresh the application as we created a new instance, and you see that I can again filter the data based on the region. And if I select, for example, this value, you will see that the price that is applied by the retailer is this, and we suggest that the best price should be 71,000. The same applies to other cars. So you can make the calculations for yourself. You can use it. And you are basically behind the scene connecting to the CAS server to display the values on the left-hand side. And on the right-hand side, you are scoring a model that was deployed into the macro analytics services. That's it for the demo. So if you want to get more information about Python SWAT, you have the links for the documentation, the same up for the SASCTL. I've written a few blogs about open source data visualization. This video is based on these two blogs. You can also get more information about Python integration into VIA. We have a bunch of blogs related to that, more than 20 blogs explaining how you can interact with SWAT and using Python, and a few blogs also more on data management or model management using the SASCTL package. Thanks for watching, and check back with the Technical Insights and Expertise series for additional tips.